And good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to the Kentucky Room of the Flatwoods Public Library. Our hostess today is Sharon Haynes, who is always our hostess today when we come here. This is our newest location. We spent a couple of years at the historic McConnell House, and we thank Bud Matheny and the board, and we may go back out there in the winter just as a matter of having a nicer place. And for someone whose head is big as Bobby's, I had to have an entire room for him here at the Flatwoods Library. Bobby Hall, the Greenham County PVA, former radio man, all-around good guy, preacher's son. You kind of liked around here a little bit, but you don't get to talk yet. We'll be back and talk to Bobby and learn all we can about this old guy right here on the Greenham Beacon Video News Magazine and the OLBH Greenham Beacon Media Network.
Heavenly Father, thank you for today. Thank you for the opportunities it holds for growth, learning, and enjoyment, and for the time to share with others. I pray for peace and joy in mind, body and spirit, and for the hope of this day. In your name, amen.
At Carmen Funeral Home, for more than 100 years, the original mission of the firm hasn't changed. They've always intended to provide the best and most professional services, complemented by the finest products. Carmen Funeral Home, people serving people since 1913, from pre-need to final arrangements. Carmen Funeral Home.
At First and People's Bank and Trust, we're not only your home office, we're your hometown bank. We're your friends, your neighbors, even your relatives. When you enter our front door, you're going to be our number one priority, because here at First and People's Bank, we're here to serve you. Tired of dealing with that corporate bank where you're just a number? Come see us at First and People's Bank and Trust, where we'll treat you just like a friend. Whether you're buying your first house, your second house, or financing a new car, come see us at First and People's Bank and Trust.
Around the corner or around the world with the Greenup Beacon.
And we're back, officially. Bobby made me move the camera up so our bellies wouldn't show today. And the only thing is, I have more hair than Bobby does. Bobby Moonbeam Hall, one of the best basketball officials I ever saw in my life.
Thank you.
And he was honored Official of the Year. I noticed that you retired after your last state tournament, but when you took the political office. That's really because he didn't want to call any fouls on Greenup, Russell, or Raceland, and it made it hard to referee.
Right.
Not true. Bobby was fair, it wouldn't matter. So, Bobby, let's start out like I do with every guest, and let's do a little virtual resume on you, where you're from, who you're married to, schools, double mom and dad,
etc. That's actually the good part of me is I'm married to Julie Harris Hall. She's grew up in Argolite. Greenup graduate. I graduated from Greenup County High School in 1986. State University. I have a bachelor's degree in communications, and I'm the son of the late Mike Hall, who was the preacher at Greenup Christian Church from 72 to 1980.
And I saw your picture on Facebook.
Yeah, good looking man.
Yeah.
And
too bad you didn't take more after him.
But. And my mother is Gleema Hall, who lives over on Bellefonte Princess Road there on Route 5. And I have a sister who lives in Raceland as the line is. She goes through Raceland to get to Russell. She lives in the Russell school system. She lives over off of Hearthstone.
Yeah, so everybody's back. Does she teach school?
No, actually, she's a trainer. She works for King's Daughters, but she subbed out to Kentucky Christian University in Grayson, and she handles all their sports medicine.
That's mates. Right. She did tell me that.
Yeah, she handles all that.
When she introduced herself, she immediately said, please do not hold this against me. So Bobby worked in the media business. He ran WLGC for a few minutes and 15 years.
I was there for about 23, 24 years.
Oh, well, the first 9 years, I must not have paid any attention. And then Bobby took the job, and Then he decided that it was time for him to pursue an opportunity to serve the people of Greenup County and ultimately the people of the state of Kentucky as a property valuation administrator, and ran, what was it, 2 years ago now? Three?
Spring of 14.
So it won't be long then.
Right.
Are you a four or six?
Four. Four-year term.
See, Judge Conley's a six, right?
I'm not sure.
Maybe not.
There's four, six, and an eight.
He might be an eight. I know that Pat Heineman and Mike Wilson are both going to pursue another term, and I've understood that Bobby Carpenter has expressed that he's going to do that. So, be a whole lot of incumbents on the upcoming. But anyway, Bob, the reason I have you here today, and we'll do this in two parts, because I have to get in the commercials, as Bobby acknowledges his understanding of commercials.
Pay the utilities.
That's correct. And buys us Diet Pop when the game's over. Bobby, tell me when you decided to run, what steps you had to go through. We're not going to talk about the campaign or the election. You know, Bill's a fine fellow.
Absolutely.
You just took the seat.
And right.
That's how it works. It wasn't an enemy thing.
Time. A great man.
Yeah.
Back in just a couple months ago, he and I were in a meeting together, and I pulled a lot of knowledge from him in that meeting. We sat there and talked for about 45 minutes, and Bill Clary's a great man.
Yeah, you can't do a job for a long time. That is the one thing that I have found, that particularly subordinates. I don't know about your experience at WLGC, but I've been at far more papers than you have radio stations, unfortunately. But, you know, people that work for me often still call me up and say, how do we do this? Well, why do we do this, and how do we do this?
Well, it's like that with anything you do in life.
Right.
Okay, if you're working at a radio station, a newspaper, wherever you're working, the hospital,
Right.
When you're there to do a job. And to
right.
do it right,
right,
and do it to the best of your ability,
right,
and to make the surroundings as good as you can possibly make them.
Right.
Then, when you leave, somebody's there to replace you.
Correct.
Their responsibility now is to take what you've done and
right.
make things better.
Right.
So whenever I leave the PVA's office, then whoever comes in and takes my place, they're supposed to take it to the next level.
Right.
And then the person after them, and et cetera. And that's what makes good
business.
Yeah,
it isn't that what you did was wrong. It's that you tried to improve it.
Yeah. And that's what it is with anything you do. I mean, it's
right.
this building, you know, that's, you remember the first libraries I
right.
ever walked into?
Right. It was over here.
800
yeah.
square feet.
Yeah.
You know,
right.
and you're bumping into each other.
Right.
If you're going to build another one, build one where you don't bump into each other,
right.
you have more to offer. So it's just, that's the way it is with any type of business.
Well, my inclination has always been, and then we'll get back to PVA, but
okay.
if you improve the product or improve the value of what you're running,
mm-hmm.
and the people that work for you are better than they were when you came, then you have done your job.
Right.
If you've held them back, or if you've destroyed the property intentionally. Not
right.
Sometimes things go downhill that you,
right.
you know, it's like I used to have a lot of friends in towns that had Kmarts, and Big Lots, and in some of those towns, those stores closed. And if you're corporately owned, they'll say, well, we're really sorry to hear that. How are you going to make that money up? And unfortunately, that isn't, you know, it's like when Armco closed. And it wasn't that the radio station suffered, it's the businesses you served
mm-hmm.
that suffered.
You know, that's very interesting that you say it. My mother and I were driving down the road one day, and She said, oh my.
You mean she'll get in the car with
this
you?
This is several years ago.
Oh, okay.
And she said, oh my. She said, what's that smell? I immediately rode the window down and I went, money.
Right.
And she said, what do you mean money? I said,
right.
Mother, as long as these plants are in business, as long as they're operating at whatever capacity it is, I said, that money is going to filter throughout this county.
Correct.
They're going to be able to provide jobs. Those people are going to go to the grocery store, the drug store, McDonald's, the restaurants, the banks, and that's how it all filters down.
And then they pay taxes to the city,
yeah.
county, and the schools.
Right. And so
right.
everything is great. But when you don't have those odors or those smells or good, bad, or indifferent,
no money.
Then there's no money.
Right.
So, you know, you can talk about the love of money or the smell of money. I'd
right.
much rather smell it.
I'd much rather have it in my pocket. We'll be back and try to do something about the PVA office here in 2 minutes, here on the OLBH Greener Beacon Media Network.
Stultz Pharmacy is special because everything they do is aimed at pleasing you, their customer. Low-priced prescription medications, their unsurpassed selection of over-the-counter medications, drop-off and pick-up, drive-through window, free blood pressure screenings, free delivery, large selection of greeting cards, collectibles, Yankee candles, and gift items for all occasions. Just a few of the things that Stultz Pharmacy offers their customers every day. Stultz Pharmacy with locations in Greenup, Flatwoods, and Wheelersburg. More than you expect from a pharmacy.
Stultz Pharmacy.
Are you an adult looking for a new career? A high school senior ready for a new and exciting journey? No matter your education goals, we have a path to get you there. We have lots of programs to help you get a high-paying job quickly or work toward a bachelor's degree. Take advantage of the state's lowest tuition, outstanding training programs for jobs in your area, and online classes. Enroll now, Ashland Community and Technical College. Higher education begins here.
Welcome to Bellefonte Animal Clinic. Dr. Amy Bess is a licensed veterinarian treating dogs, cats, and other small animals. Your pet's health and well-being are very important, and Dr. Bess and staff will take every step to give your pet the best possible care. Bellefonte Animal Clinic is a full-service animal clinic and will take routine wellness cases as well as medical, surgical, and dental issues. Dr. Amy Bess. Bellefonte Animal Clinic, 1500 Kenwood Drive, Russell. Call 606-836-9933.
All drivers are not as careful as you are, and Kurt Robinson State Farm Insurance in Flatwoods reminds you to drive carefully at all times. For all your insurance needs, auto, home, life, and health, contact Kurt Robinson Insurance with over 28 years as a State Farm agent. Phone 836-3011. Auto quotes available 24/7 at 836-3011. Kurt Robinson Insurance, 1114 Bellefonte Road in Flatwoods.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Hank Bond and the world famous Bobby Hall here on the Green and Beacon Video News Magazine, our weekly news show. And Bobby, I've been thinking, since you're an old media boy, I talked to Liz Fairchild over at IHOP. She's back as the manager. And I'm thinking about doing a Friday morning show, Hank and Bobby. And we could join there from 6:30 to 8:30 on Fridays. They'd feed us pancakes. And we could just do one of the Hal Murphy style shows where people just walk by. And, you know, free breakfast is worth a couple hours of your time.
I mean, the only thing better than a home-cooked meal is a free one.
Amen to that. So Bobby's a PBA in Greenup County. His first political endeavor, I don't know if you held offices in the associations you were in, but he is an elected official, constitutional office. In every county has one. So Bobby, when you decided to run, did you had to take a test and do things like that?
The way it's set up is every office is different. In your city government, you have city council members and mayors.
Right.
And those positions are nonpartisan. And in Greenup County, we have eight cities. And then when you go to the courthouse, you have county government. So you have your judge executive, your sheriff, your county attorney, mm-hmm. your three county commissioners. And then you also have a county clerk, which is what Pat Heineman does. And then you have two other positions, and those are the circuit court clerk, right. which is Alan Reed, and the property valuation administrator, which is me. And the property valuation administrator and the circuit court clerk are both Frankfort government jobs.
Right. Okay?
Everything else falls under county government. Allen's office and my office falls under state government.
So basically your direct deposit comes from Frankfort.
Absolutely. And so does everyone on my staff. So everyone, our retirement is state retirement. Allen's office, all of his staff, their state retirement. Then everyone else are county. Now, the thing that that's the only thing that separates us. Everything else is the same, meaning that they're all elected positions by the residents either in that city for the city council members and mayors, and with everybody in the county with all the other positions in the courthouse and the annex.
Right.
So that's the way it's, everything's broken down from that standpoint. Several years ago, my wife and I were talking, and you know, wherever we go, you've known me for a long time. I'm not very bashful, and I speak to everyone, try to smile and enjoy life. And she said, Bobby, she said, have you ever thought about getting into the public, in the public perspective of elected officials? I said, no, not really. Well, this conversation just kept going and going and going. And so finally I came home one day and I said, you know what? I said, I think I'm going to run for office. And she said, okay, whatever you want to do. She said, I'm 100% behind you. That's what I tell people first. First and foremost, if you're going to run for an elected office,
your spouse needs to be
100% on board. And believe me, she was. Then I went and spoke with her mom and dad, my mom, and I made sure everybody in my family was on board, because we're taking a big risk. So this was over a course of a 2-year period, and we kept it very quiet. And then I found out that there was the date of the test, and the PVA test is given in Lawrenceburg, Kentucky, right next to Frankfort, over at in this huge facility. And it says, bring your driver's license and tell it, well, you have to live in that county for a year, and you must be 25 years old, and you're going to take a test. And the test is 3.5 hours in length, and you have nothing to study by. There's 100 questions, 50 from the math side of it, 25 vocabulary words, and 25 reading comprehension. No study guide. Okay, so I decided to take off and drive to Frankfort on that Thursday night. And I get there about 10:30, and I go to Lawrenceburg and check into a hotel. I'm sorry, sir, we're out of rooms. I said, where's the closest room? I said, there's one room left at the Hampton over in Frankfort. I said, that's the only room left in about a 20-mile radius. I said, really? I said, what's going on? They said, there's this big test going on in town. I just kind of smiled. So I went down, checked in until they got that last room, got up the next morning. And I pull into this parking lot, and there's just cars everywhere. And I have no idea. All of this is just shocking. And I look around, and I'm seeing every county you can imagine. There's like 500, 600 people in this room. And so we sit down, and everybody, they take the test. They have these monitors of people walking everywhere, you know, and you're nervous. You don't know what's going on. You don't want anybody to know you took it, because if you fail it, you don't want them. You know how your buddies are going to gig you.
Right,
you know how you and I
right,
gig each other,
right.
Elbow you. So we told nobody that I was going to take this test. So 3 hours and 15 minutes passes. I'm walking 400 yards back to my truck. My brain's just fried. I'm demoralized. I pick up my cell phone. I call my wife and I said, well, she said, how'd it go? I said, well, I think we're staying in the radio business. And she said, what do you mean? I said, that was the hardest test I've ever taken in my life.
And I've heard that.
And I said, we're staying in the radio business. That was a 2.5-hour ride from Frankfort. So felt like 6 days coming
home. Oh, I know.
So I come back, and back in the radio days, we had our offices were in Ashland, but we kept our post office box in Greenup. So when I would go to Scioto County in Greenup to sell advertising, I would always stop at the post office on Tuesdays and Thursdays. Well, when we left taking the test, they gave us a business card with this address on it. It said, go on, Google this, and it'll tell you everyone who's passed the test. It doesn't say who failed it. It just says who passed it.
Which is good.
Which is great. So it saves some embarrassment. Since I didn't tell nobody, if I failed it, I would have been good.
Right.
So I won't look. It's Tuesday, I won't look. It's Wednesday, I won't look. It's already been posted, but I'm scared to death to look, because I'm afraid I won't see my name. At 10 o'clock on Thursday morning, I pulled into the post office. I opened up my truck door. That little card with that email web address is in my door handle. And the guy gets out of a vehicle and he says, hey, he said, you going to run for PVA? I said, I probably would if I passed that test. And he said, you passed it. I said, really? He said, yeah. I said, well, come here. I hadn't even got my foot out the door. He walked over. I said, read me that address. I Google it. I zip down, find Greenup County, and there's my name. So that happened at 10 o'clock on Thursday morning. At 4 o'clock on Thursday evening, that same day,
you signed up.
I signed up to run for PVA.
I'm glad you did.
Thanks.
You know, we'll be back with Bobby Hall for our final segment to talk about what he actually does in this high-paid, no-stress, that's not true, high-paid job at, I wouldn't say state capitol, but we'll go with the Greenup County Courthouse. Best thing is he learned how to paint walls. There you go. We'll be back in a minute on the OLBH Greenup Beacon Media Network. Betty Guyon and the Greenup County EMS want you to know the qualified staff is available to you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. For transport, call 833-1515. And for medical emergencies, call 911. Greenup County EMS, when seconds count, accepting Medicaid, private insurance, and private pay. Greenup County EMS.
Brent Roark's Insurance Agency is a full-service agency associated with Nationwide Insurance, one of the largest insurance companies in the United States. Nationwide's financial strength remains strong. To reach Brent Roark at 721 Belfond Road in Flatwoods, phone 836-6666.
Nationwide is on your side.
Music from Mother, Father, Sister, Brother, 1974.
I'm just glad you didn't ask me to sing.
Well, I thought you were lucky to get elected, so I know how many sing. We were talking about Bobby painting the walls, and he went in and took what Mr. Clary has done and added some paint to it, and you've upgraded your technology a little bit, you mm-hmm. said, and. So let's talk about your technology, and let's talk about, we don't talk about the people down there, but let's talk about what you've done with technology, what the PVA actually does. One of the things I want you to do address is the Homestead Exemption Act.
Okay.
Because I have lots of friends my age that do not realize that a certain portion of your taxes can be, you don't have to pay them once you reach 65.
Right. Well, let's start with that.
Okay.
In the past, what I'd done the previous 2 years is I would just buy ads in newspapers and wish people a happy birthday if you're turning 65.
Right.
This year. So it was helping some, but it still mm-hmm. wasn't reaching everybody that I needed mm-hmm. to reach. Mm-hmm. So this year I went a different avenue and it worked out fantastic. I mean, it's really exciting. And the reason it's exciting is because it makes the number true. And
right.
I'll explain the number true in just a minute. But the homestead is set for a 2 year period. Okay? Whatever that dollar amount is this year, which is new this year, okay, the governor increases it every 2 years. So for example, this year it's $37,600. Last year it was $36,900. Okay? So we've increased it $700 this year under the direction of the governor. Well, when he did that this year, that automatically by statute puts that into effect for 17 and 18.
Okay.
So that $37,600 will be there for 2 years. After that, it will be adjusted either up or down, but it's never been down. So we hope it stays
at least
with
the same. Right.
The same or grows.
Right.
So what I've done this year was I found out that Frankfort started a program where you could call down there and they would send you a report of every person in your county that's turning 65 in the year 2017.
That is a property owner.
That is a property owner. So I was excited. So they send that to me. Well, when they sent it to me, what I did was I went back into the computer base and I looked at every one of those properties. And the reason I did that, Hank, is if you're 65 and you're already getting it, okay, but Marilyn, your wife, is not, and it's her birthday, and I sent that to her, then she would get excited and say, hey, we're going to get another 37.6 off. Well, that's not the way it works.
Right. So
you're allowed one per household, and you must live in that house. So you might own 10 houses in Greenup County.
Right, but the only one that matters is
the one you live in, you get the homestead.
Mm-hmm.
Now, on the homestead, it counts for one of two things, 100% disability, okay, or age of 65 or older. So I went through, me and a couple of the people in our office, we went through every single name. We wanted to make sure that we sent it to the people who didn't already have it.
Okay? Right, right.
That's also going to save cost. It's going to save money.
Right.
And it's going to save confusion. Confusion
right.
be the number one thing. We didn't want any confusion. So we found that that number, and it came out to like 112 people.
Right.
So I drafted up a letter, and in the letter I explained, congratulations, and I think that's how it started off, happy birthday from the PVA office. Please bring your driver's license and come see me as soon as you can. We're going to take $37,600 off of your assessment this year. We had over 60 people respond.
Nice.
Well, that was exciting. And the reason that's exciting is because the state frowns on exonerations, meaning I'm done with 2017 right now. In May, we're finished with 17. We're working on 18 now because of the process of everything.
Sure.
So if you come in November and when the tax bill's already been printed and you say, hey, Bobby, I'm 65. I need the homestead. Well, I still give it to you. Be glad to. Want to.
Right.
But I have to exonerate it out. And when I exonerate it out, then that changes all the numbers to all those taxing districts.
Right.
So if there's anything I can do to pre-plan
right.
to make it...
It helps everybody.
It helps everybody.
Right.
And it goes back to the statement I made a few minutes ago, it makes the number true.
Right.
Okay? So when you set your budget at all the taxing districts throughout the county, I want to make that money come true
as
and not
close
have to
right.
as possible.
Right. Right. Right.
So anything I can do to help, and then what I'm doing is I'm not just helping the taxing districts, but I'm helping everybody in the county.
Right.
And that's the number one objective.
Right. So you stay busy.
Oh, I love it. Yes.
So now tell me how properties are evaluated.
Okay. It's a cycle, and it's called a quad. And the quad means you split the county up into four sections.
Right.
And this is for every county in the state of Kentucky. So we go to section one this year. Next year we go to section two, section three, section four. By law, we have to do that. So we're going to see your house every 4 years for sure. Then, after we do that quad, this year, section one, after we get that quad completed, and what I mean by completed is we go out, we drive and visibly see every one of those properties. And what we're looking for is not to raise anybody. By law, we put on the tax roll. So if we put the new on, then that's good enough to grow, because we're going to be taking stuff off because of unfortunate fires, catastrophes of some kind. So then when we get done with that quad, then the next statute tells us that we have to drive the entire county and look at the entire county. Okay. The first part of it, we go really slow. We're looking.
Right.
So after we do that quad, then we have to visibly look at the other three, just to look to see if there's any new growth. Okay?
Sure.
We're not going out and looking. In this quad, where we're number one this year, we will take a lot of pictures for updating. Okay? If we see you've changed your siding, your windows, well, the windows are 3,000, siding's 5,000, whatever the case may be, we have a price structure set on, then we'll send you a letter saying, hey, here's a letter of notification. We see you've increased, or you've added value to your house, here's what it is, and then you have an opportunity to appeal that. And then that's a great question too. Thanks for asking the one that you haven't asked yet. The thing I'm the most happiest about right now is
most happiest?
Most happiest. Would it be most happiest? Or
that would be happiest.
Okay, the thing I'm happiest about is that this is the first year that we, and I don't know how far back this dates, but several years, bunches of years, that this is the first year.
Bunches
of years.
These ones.
Huge years. This is the first time we've never had an appeal come before the local board of appeals.
Nice.
And people say, well, why are you so excited about that? Because I'm excited about that because that gives me energy thinking, I've worked with you. I've listened to you. I've helped you. We've worked it out together. We've come up with what's fair.
You fairly done your job.
Exactly. And so I'm really excited about that.
That's good.
It took 2.5 years to get there, but we're there. You got to come see the place. We painted it. We got new monitors up.
He has donuts every day.
How can you tell?
Yeah. So, Bobby, how many people are in your office?
I have six full-time employees with state benefits, and everything's great.
Now, these people that go out and look at the homes, are they of those six people?
Yes.
Okay, so it's all done? You don't bring in contractors?
No, sir. We do everything right here at home.
Okay. We'll be back with Bobby Hall one final time here on the OLBH Green & Beacon Media Network.
Heavenly Father, thank you for today. Thank you for the opportunities it holds for growth, learning, and enjoyment, and for the time to share with others. I pray for peace and joy in mind, body, and spirit, and for the hope of this day. In your name, amen.
At First and People's Bank and Trust, we're not only your home office, we're your hometown bank. We're your friends, your neighbors, even your relatives. When you enter our front door, you're going to be our number one priority because here at First and People's Bank, we're here to serve you. Tired of dealing with that corporate bank where you're just a number? Come see us at First and People's Bank and Trust, where we'll treat you just like a friend. Whether you're buying your first house, your second house, or financing a new car, come see us at First and People's Bank and Trust.
Around the corner or around the world with the Green Up Beacon.
I wanted to tell you though, here's a story on Bobby Hall. We're not going to talk any more PVA business.
Are we live?
Oh, we're on.
We might need a 10-second delay or something.
No, there is no delay for this. Back a couple months ago, Chuck Dunlap called me up and said they're having this Legends of Radio, Mike Tussey, and they had it up at Mike Kirtner's place at up on, is that Fifth Avenue maybe?
Yeah.
And I went, and I got called a legend. And I'm up there thinking, I spent 10 years trying to get a job in Huntington, and they're going to call me a legend now. But you know, there were a lot of people there that knew me, but my favorite part was, you know, like in anything like that, to have you go around the room and they say how you started in radio. And so I pulled out my best Ted Knight and said it all started at a 1,000 watt radio station, WBTH in Williamson. But it was a great time. But I wanted to point out that Bobby Hall's not a legend because he didn't come. Just saying.
I was out of town. That's a good answer.
That's his excuse. We'd like to say hi to Sherry Noble down there wherever you are, and to our audience today. Bobby and I enjoy doing this probably as much as anything because no pressure.
We get to catch up on a lot of stuff when we're off the air.
Yeah, when we're off mic, it's dangerous. But I even comb my hair and I did everything. Of course, Bobby didn't have to do that.
I'd like to have some of that.
That's what I'm saying. Bobby didn't have to do that. Bobby, thanks for being on the show today. I do appreciate it very much.
Thanks for having me.
I'm sure you'll be on the ballot for the next go around, and you've done a good job.
Thank you.
As did Bill, and I'm sure that you'll continue to do a good job for the people of the county.
We'll try hard.
See you out on that trail.
All right, sounds good. Thanks, Hank.
Bobby Hall here on the Green & Beacon Video News Magazine, and this is Hank Bond. Join us again next week. Stand by. I got to wait on here. Got to get this message up in my window. There it is. Come on, baby. Next week, it is Tim Rice, the Russell baseball coach, and Greenup County attorney Mike Wilson, right here on the Greenup Beacon Video News Magazine. Have a great week. Thank you very much.